Hello. So it's a privilege to be here for Alistair Hulett. I only met him once, that was in Sydney, and his band played with my band as a firecracker of a man.
Oh, it looks really beautiful. When we came in, it wasn't all lit up like this. It looks fantastic. Okay, so the first song we're going to do, I'm Naomi, this is Paul. The first song we're going to do is a song from my last album. I did a murder ballads album, and which is a particularly cheery album. And this is a song from that album. It's called Daddy's Got a Gun. And it's a story, it's a true story, and I'm sure a lot of you will remember the story because it was really high profile in the papers. There was a millionaire, or a billionaire from Shropshire, I think, and he was living a lie. He, by having that music going on at the same time, I feel like I'm on that, what was that Simon Bates show, or what was it, that kind of, do you remember that one?
Our Tune.
Yeah, so it feels like. which seems really inappropriate for the song. so basically, yeah, this millionaire from Shropshire, he was living a lie and he lost all of his money and he killed his wife and he killed his 15-year-old daughter and he shot the dog and he shot the horses and he burnt the mansion down. And it's just a very, very depressing story. And we kind of heard that the day before he went on this killing spree, he'd been at a barbecue and he had said that he would rather die than be poor. And it seemed like such a horrendous thing to say. And this song came about over a conversation that Paul and I had over my kitchen table about this situation. So this is Daddy's Got a Gun.
Still here, still
next tune is from their most recent second record. It's actually for sale back there. It's called Raise These Sails, and this one's about the voyage of the Mayflower. Well, it's not really. It's actually about the stuff they took on board the Mayflower. I was doing a little bit of work at the University of Southampton, where they've got a fantastic archive of local history, and I came across the, I think what they call the bill of lading for the provisions. And some of the provisions they took on the Mayflower, they just struck my imagination. So it's actually a song, it's a list, really, it's a list song. It's a list of things they took. Hopefully all adding up to something more than a list.
Soon freeze, yards of linen, bombs, and blues of leather. Best of all,
spitting kettle, skillet, scoop, both the porridge, both the soup, ribbon laid out, needle cradle. So
speed and axe, shovel, hatchet, iron, tag, sword and sickle.
Rake and hoe, bushel of oatmeal, bushel of peas, barrel of butter, barrel of cheese, juice of lemon, and water. So raise these sails and gray.
Musket, 60 pound of lead, 20 pound of powder. As the Lord has said,
as the Lord has said, for the sickness and the seed water, for the beaver, willow, bark, like ancient Moses, ancient Noah. In Southampton, destination still unknown, is whispered. Very shortly, we're going to be having a special guest. We've got Mr. Justin Currie joining us. And this next song that we're about to sing is actually the antithesis of anything that Justin would ever sing or ever write. Which you could tell by the title, because it's called A Life That's Good. And this song is, Paul and I watched this really trashy programme, which we love.
Guilty pleasures.
Yeah, which we love, called Nashville. I don't know if any of you watch it. Yeah, so this song we first heard on Nashville. So this is A Life That's Good. On somebody with the initials JC.
I reckon he's never heard that one before.
It accused my messianic sense of self.
So this song that we're going to do, it's a song called Gypsy Davy. It's on my new album, which is called A History of Insolence, and Justin's got a few songs on the album with me. And this is a song that I first heard as a kid by a woman called Jean Ritchie, and I loved Jean Ritchie's version of this song. But a few years ago, I heard a version by Woody Guthrie, because all of the versions I'd ever heard of this song, and I heard quite a few, all of them, the woman in the song, she leaves her rich lord and she runs off with a gypsy, but she basically always loses her money or loses her man or in some form or other gets utterly fucked by the situation. But in the Woody Guthrie version, the gypsy that she runs off with is a musician, and she sits around the campfire sort of staring at him over the guitar, and she runs off with him and she gets to keep her baby and she keeps the money. And so I've kind of bastardized a few of the different versions I've heard of this song, and me and Justin kind of came up with this one, which is Gypsy Davy. Well, you came up with some of
it. I didn't do it.
Well, you came up with a chorus, and we came up with your lovely melody. I didn't do that. Currie. And that is one that we wrote together. Yeah, that song we did write together, you can't kind of deny that one. Okay, this next song. Anybody who knows me, or anyone I should say who is friends with me on Facebook, will know that I've got really bad Facebook OCD, and I'm one of those people who just posts like 20 times a day, and I'm particularly annoying, and I never go and befriend anybody because I always never want to put myself on anybody, so I never befriend anyone, but I do always accept friend requests, and but I do get quite irritating. And on Valentine's Day a few years ago, I remember moaning like, of all the different countries in the world and of all the different hundreds and thousands and millions of people there were in the world, nobody had got me a Valentine's Day card. And I kind of continued, it kind of escalated my posts did throughout the day. And when I got home, I felt really guilty because Paul had actually written me this song, Bluebirds. And it was my Valentine's Day present.
You're going to ruin my reputation. Persistence, really. It's about a man I knew who was old and dying, and his legs were in a terrible state. He had two walking sticks, and He lived in a small room and his life had obviously gone to the bad. But every day he walked up a steep hill to the pub at the top and he walked down again off his couple of pints that he had. And it took him up to an hour and a half to walk to the pub, and that's a bit quicker to get back actually. He stopped coming in and I asked and he'd died. And I found out that he had once been a proud boxer and he'd fought for the British Championship, won it. And after that, it gone to the merchant sea. And I was so moved by his effort that he made every single day to walk up the hill. And sometimes it's the little things, the little acts of resistance that prove our character, I suppose. And I wrote the song called The Hill, because I think everybody's got their own hill, really.
History of Incidents, and it's a song really about religion. It's quite apt for the moment, really. It's basically a song, you know, when people find faith, it's kind of, why can't people be content with their own faith rather than feeling the need to force their beliefs onto other people? And this song is basically about that, and it's called Overseas. John came down a dusty road to be a pilgrim. He drank from the holy shore and took it with him. In his eyes, his master's words like a virus. Rose in a burning land, gathered his people. Sing that chorus with me. Okay, this is another true story. This is from my last album, the Murder Ballads album. In fact, the Murder Ballads album, I extended the album to include death as well as murder after I heard this song, because I wanted to include this on the album. And it's another one of Paul's songs. And it's a true story about this woman who got up in the middle of the night to get a glass of water. Her husband got up in the middle of the night to get a glass of water and he fell down the stairs and he died. So it's not particularly happy, this song, but it has got this really beautiful ending in the last verse. But this is The Clouds of Colwyn Bay.
To the dark, twisting clouds of...
me. But welcome, my love, and all you'll be getting. You're just 6.5 weeks inside me. The Alistair Hulett Memorial for inviting us to come and play today. It really is an honour to play in his memory. So thank you very much for that. And just thank you in general to Celtic Connections. It's brilliant to be able to come and play in Glasgow again. It's been a long time. Well, it's been a couple of years. And I remember that the last time I played at Celtic Connections, I had somebody telling me to get to fuck, and I was really hoping that someone was going to say that to me again today. So if anyone wants to buy me a drink at the end and just wants to go, I have this just funny little perverse thing where I just really like to be told to get to fuck. So please feel free. So
thanks to Joan Byers for saying that to me.
Joan Byers, potty mouth. Again, this is from the last album, and this is a song that Justin and I wrote, and it's called One of a Kind. He's not the big man who'll make things all right. He's weak, and when you're weak, that's when he'll
he
to have an interval now, a short interval of 15 minutes, and then we'll be back with James and Nancy. See you then.